It's easy to see this case as one man trying to prove his innocence. But when you take a black man and you put him on death row a year before his trial, and exclude black people from serving on his jury, when you base your conviction on the coerced testimony of a white felon, and ignore the testimony of 24 law-abiding black witnesses, when any evidence proving his innocence is suppressed and anyone who tries to tell the truth is threatened, this case becomes more than the trial of just a single defendant. It becomes a test of whether we're going to be governed by fear and by anger or by the rule of law. If the people standing in the back of this courtroom are all presumed guilty when accused, if they have to leave here and live in fear of when this very thing will happen to them, if we're just going to accept the system that treats you better if you're rich and guilty than if you're poor and innocent, then we can't claim to be just. If we say we're committed to equal justice under law, to protecting the rights of every citizen, regardless of wealth, race, or status, then we have to end this nightmare for Walter McMillian and his family. The charges against them have been proven to be a false construction of desperate people, fueled by bigotry and bias, who ignored the truth in exchange for easy solutions, and that's not the law. That's not justice. That's not right. I ask that this case be dismissed immediately, Your Honor. Thank you.